In this video, we're given that a rock is thrown horizontally off of a bridge with a speed of 25 meters per second, and the height of this bridge is unknown. What we know is the time it takes for that rock to hit the water down below. In part A, we're going to use that time to get the height of the bridge, and then in part B, we're going to get the final speed of that rock when it hits the water. You might also call that the impact speed. So getting into part A here, the key point is that the initial y velocity is zero. All that initial velocity is in the x direction. So if we just make a quick list of everything we know about the y direction, I'm going to put the origin at the level of the water, which means the initial height is h. That's the unknown height of the bridge. The final height is zero. The y acceleration is just negative g because we have free fall near the surface of the earth. Initial y velocity is zero. The final y velocity we're interested in part B. And then the time for this fall is 3.5 seconds. And we'll be using 9.8 for the approximate acceleration of gravity. So this is a negative 9.8 meters per second squared. So to relate all the knowns and unknowns here, I just use my first kinematics equation, y equals y naught plus v naught yt plus 1/2 ayt squared, where that y acceleration is given by negative g. I plug everything in. Remember, the initial y velocity is zero. Ay is negative 9.8. I just move the minus sign out in front. And our fall time is 3.5 seconds. So I can smash the numbers here. 1/2 times 9.8 times 3.5 squared. Move that to the other side of the equation, and I've got h. Into three significant digits, I get 60.0 meters. In part B, I want the final speed when the rock hits the water. And the x component of this final velocity, that's the easy part. In projectile motion, the x velocity never changes. So when it impacts the water, that rightward component is still 25 meters per second. Now, during the flight, the rock picks up a downward component to its velocity, and that's the final y velocity. Now, we're going to find that final y velocity by using our second kinematics equation. So I have vy final is equal to v naught y plus ayt, where the acceleration in the y direction, again, is just given by negative 9.8 meters per second squared. Remember, our initial y velocity is zero, so I simply have negative 9.8 meters per second squared times 3.5 seconds. This gives me a final y velocity of negative 34.3 meters per second. So in my diagram, that's just a downward component with a length of 34.3. Finally, to answer the question, we needed the final speed when the rock hits the water. And that's the hypotenuse of this triangle that I've drawn. So my final speed, which I called VF in the diagram, is going to be the square root of the sum of the squares of the legs here. So that's 25 squared plus a 34.3 squared. Notice that the minus sign on VY doesn't matter there. We're just taking the magnitude of that side and squaring it. And when I run the numbers on this, I get 42.4 meters per second. And we're done. If you enjoyed this video or at least found it useful, check out another one by clicking one of the links on the left, or click the Zach's Lab logo on the right to explore dozens of physics and math playlists. As always, you can leave your questions, comments, and requests in the comments section below, and I'll get back to you within 24 hours. Thanks for watching Zach's Lab, and best of luck on your math and physics journey.